Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the part 2 of the September best multiple choice questions, that is best 200 question, the remaining 100 from 16 to 30th of September. So let's start the video. You can connect with me on Instagram for all the updates regarding videos or other announcements. This is my ID. You can also search me by my name. It's not very difficult to find me on Instagram. And this month we are having our biggest sale of the year. It is the Diwali sale. So last year also it was our most successful and it is our flagship, the most important sale. It is for 2 weeks from 17th to 31st of October. So if you want to avail heavy discounts on pen drive, tablet or Android courses, then just visit our website studyiq.com or you can also dial this number 9580048004. Now let's start the video. Before I start, let's do a quick review of the important days in the second half of September. World Water Monitoring Day is September the 18th. World Water Monitoring Day. World Patient Safety Day is 17th of September. And this time the theme was Patient Safety, a Global Health Priority. And the slogan was Speak Up for Patient Safety. World Alzheimer Day. Alzheimer disease is a very important neurological disease. It is a disease of the brain. And Alzheimer disease was on September the 21st. This time the theme was raising awareness and challenging the stigma. A few more. International Day of the Peace is again 21st of September. The theme this time was climate action for peace. It is one of the most important days. Remember it. International Day of Democracy is September the 15th. India is the largest democracy in the world and America is the oldest democracy in the world. This time the theme was participation. International Day for the Preservation of the Ozone Layer, which filters out the harmful ultraviolet rays and protects the earth, and it lies in stratosphere. It is also called as World Ozone Day. It is on 16th of September. Remember, there was a Montreal Protocol also for the protection of the ozone layer. The theme was 32 years and healing. Then we have International Day of Sign Languages, 23rd of September. This time the theme was Sign Language Rights for All. 28th of September is the World Rabies Day. And World Heart Day is September 29. Remember, World Heart Day and World Rabies Day are very important. And the theme for World Heart Day is equally important. It is My Heart, Your Heart. Now let's take a look at a few very important people who died. This is obituaries. Malayalam writer. He was from Kerala. Sivaraman Cheriyanath, he passed away. Film editor Sanjeev Kumar Datta, he edited hit movies like Iqbal, Ek Haseena Thi and Mardani. Robert Garrison, he was an actor. He was born in Poland. Then the famous American singer and songwriter Eddie Money passed away. Renowned film director Shyam Ramsey, he was one half of the Ramsey brothers who were very popular for directing the horror movies. Jack Chirac, again very important, he was the former president of France. Right now the French president is Emmanuel Macron and his party name is En Marche. American television producer, he was 4 times Emmy award winner, J. Michael Mandel, also passed away. Former president of Tunisia, Zine El Abidine Ben Ali, passed away. This is also very important. Famous actor S.K. Padmadevi, he was part of the first Kannada talkie film. Bhagat Ram Vats, he was a journalist and he used to travel extensively with the former Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru. He passed away. Former football player from Netherlands, Fernando Riksen, passed away. Madhav Apte was a cricketer, Madhav Apte, and Robert Boyd, he was a Pulitzer Prize winning journalist. He also passed away. Now let's take a look at 4 or 5 important books during these 15 days. There is a book written by Paro Anand. It is Being Gandhi. Being Gandhi. There is a book about the governance of Modi, which is Turbulence and Triumph. Turbulence and Triumph, the Modi Years, written by 2 people, Rahul Agarwal and Bharti Pradhan. Then there is a book written by Dhaval Kulkarni. It is about Uddhav Thackeray and Raj Thackeray, the cousins Thackeray. And you can see in the center, we have Balasaheb Thackeray himself. So the book is called The Cousins Thackeray, Uddhav, Raj and the Shadow of Their Senas. That is the Maharashtra Nav Nirman Sena and the Shiva Sena. Then we have a book called Leeches Slug Glue. Basically, from leeches to slug glue. It's a book about modern medicine. Then there is a book written by Neha Hiranandani called Girl Power. Girl Power. And the most important book is Reset. It is written by BJP's Rajya Sabha Member of Parliament Subramanyam Swami. He is a renowned economist from Harvard University. So the book is called Reset. There is a book written by Siddharth Sanghvi. He is an award-winning author. And the book is called Loss. Now let's return to the MCQ format. September the 15th, it is celebrated as National Engineers Day, right? It is celebrated in India, but also in two other countries. Now, which countries are those? For those who don't know, National Engineers Day is the birthday of Dr. M. Vishweswarya, Mokshakundam Vishweswarya. So, you know, there are two other countries in which it is celebrated as National Engineers Day, Sri Lanka and Tanzania. Tanzania is famous for Mount Kilimanjaro, and Mount Kilimanjaro is the highest peak of African continent. Name the India's first company which has provided broadband services to the maritime sector. It is Nelco. Nelco. So Nelco is owned by Tata. Remember that also. Sometimes in the option you may not get Nelco, but you will surely get Tata. And Ravi Shankar Prasad is the Minister for Communication, Electronics, Information Technology, Law and Justice. So, he inaugurated this service provided by Nelco. President Ramnath Kovind inaugurated a bronze statue of Mahatma Gandhi in which city of Switzerland? This city is called Villeneuve. Villeneuve. Now remember, last year in Sydney also, a statue of Mahatma Gandhi was inaugurated by Ramnath Kovind. And remember, Mahatma Gandhi visited Villeneuve in 1931. Which state government has decided that the chief minister and other state ministers will pay their own income tax? So far, the income tax was paid by the state exchequer. It has been decided by the government of Uttar Pradesh, UP. The government is launching a major program. They are offering 1000 PhD fellowships to the students of which organization at IITs in India. So IITs will have 1000 PhD seats reserved for the ASEAN countries. The answer is ASEAN. You know there are 10 ASEAN countries and they are headquartered in Jakarta, which is the capital of Indonesia. Actually the former capital, the new capital will be East Kalimantan, which is in Borneo. Union Minister for Environment and Forest and Climate Change, Prakash Javadekar, he flagged off a Jal Doot vehicle in which city? Jal Doot vehicle was flagged off in Pune, Maharashtra. And this van carrying the Save Water message will travel to different parts of Maharashtra. An innovative project for constructing a floating school for marginalized children in which country has been awarded the prestigious Aga Khan Architecture Award? Aga Khan Architecture Award is one of the most prestigious awards, and Aga Khan Architecture Award has been given to Bangladesh for 2019. Which country has become the 79th member of International Solar Alliance? It is Saint Vincent and the Grenadines. I'm sure you must have not heard about this country. Saint Vincent and the Grenadines. It has become the 79th country to join the International Solar Alliance. It is headquartered in Gurugram in Haryana. Union Minister for Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Dr. Mahinder Nath Pandey, he laid down the foundation stone for the Indian Institute of Skills in which city recently? Indian Institute of Skills will be set up in three places: Mumbai, Ahmedabad and Kanpur. Recently it was inaugurated. Not inaugurated, the foundation stone was kept in Mumbai. So the answer is Mumbai. But remember, Indian Institute of Skills will come up in Mumbai, Ahmedabad and Kanpur. The world's first malaria vaccine, it was recently launched in which country? Malaria vaccine was launched recently in Kenya. Kenya's capital is Nairobi. And in Kenya, we also have the Masai Mara National Park, which is very famous. It is asked in exams also. So this vaccine could be a game changer for malaria elimination. UNESCO has decided to translate and publish an anthology. Anthology is a collection of poems, right? So anthology of the writings of which Sikh Guru in world languages? It is Guru Nanak Dev. The first Sikh Guru was Guru Nanak Dev. Total, there are 11 Sikh Gurus. The 11th Sikh Guru is Guru Granth Sahib, which is the holy book of Sikhs. And after that, there are no Sikh Gurus. Which country has topped the CPJ, Committee to Protect Journalists, list of worst countries for press censorship? Press censorship means when the government does not allow you to publish against it. So the worst country for press censorship is Eritrea, and second worst is North Korea. Now let me show you the 10 worst countries for being a journalist. The worst is Eritrea, and the second worst is North Korea. Third worst is Turkmenistan. Which movie has become the only Indian film to feature in the Guardian's list of 100 best films of the 21st century? If you remember last year, BBC gave a list of 100 best films of 21st century. Only one Indian movie was there, which is Pathar Panchali by Satyajit Ray. But in the Guardian's list, only one movie is there, which is Gangs of Wasseypur. It is directed by Anurag Kashyap. Which country has won the Basketball World Cup that was held in the capital of China, Beijing? So Spain defeated Argentina to win the Basketball World Cup. Very important question. And remember, the next Basketball World Cup will take place in 2023 in Japan, Indonesia, and Philippines. All the three countries will host it together. American President Donald Trump, he joined PM Narendra Modi for a mega event called Howdy Modi. Now, this event was held in which city? It was held in Houston. Houston. Polish means something that belongs to Poland is Polish. So, Polish World War II Memorial Pillar. It was recently inaugurated in which city? It was inaugurated in Kolhapur in Maharashtra. Kolhapur in Maharashtra. Who has won the Best Actress Award at the India International Film Festival of Boston, America? It is Nina Gupta. And she won the Best Actress Award for the movie Badhai Ho. Right? And she also acted in a movie called The Last Color. So it was like a double celebration for her. The answer is Nina Gupta. Neer Mahal Jal Utsav was recently concluded in which state? Neer Mahal is a very iconic monument in Tripura. So the answer is Tripura. Dikshi Hydroelectric Project was recently inaugurated in which state? It was inaugurated in Arunachal Pradesh. It was inaugurated in Arunachal Pradesh in the West Kameng district. West Kameng district. And it is made on a river which is called Fudungto River. Phudungto. Fudungto River. 11th International Rent Dink Award has been won by an Indian. What is her name? Her name is Agnes Kharshing. And why has she won it? Because she took on coal mafia almost single-handedly in Meghalaya. So the state she belongs to is Meghalaya. There is a military exercise called SITMAX. It took place between three countries. India, Singapore, and which was the third country? The third country was Thailand. Thailand. Another question. Where did this take place? It took place in Port Blair, which is the capital of Andaman and Nicobar. The Ministry of Commerce and Industry, through the Export Credit Guarantee Corporation, which is called ECGC, they have introduced which export credit insurance scheme? This scheme is called NIRVIC. NIRVIC. It's a new scheme to enhance the loan availability. And NIRVIC has a full form also, which is called Niryat Rin Vikas Yojana. Yojana is scheme, Vikas is development, Rin is loan, and Niryat is export. So export loan development scheme or NIRVIC. Who has been conferred Dr. Kalam Smriti International Excellence Award? Don't confuse it with APJ Kalam Award. APJ Kalam Award was given to K. Sivan. He is the chairman of ISRO. But Dr. Kalam Smriti International Excellence Award was given to Sheikh Hasina. She is the Prime Minister of Bangladesh. India has commenced a special training program for the civil servants of which two countries? They will get training in Lal Bahadur Shastri Academy in Mussoorie in Uttarakhand. The civil servants of Maldives and Bangladesh will be trained in Mussoorie. Maldives and Bangladesh. Mukhyamantri Seva Sankalp Helpline, which is 1100. You can dial this number in which state? It is for the speedy redressal of the public grievances to resolve the complaints of the citizens of Himachal Pradesh. What is the full form of SIMS? It is something which has been recently launched by the Government of India. What is SIMS? SIMS stands for Steel Import Monitoring System. Steel Import Monitoring System. India has successfully test-fired air-to-air missile called Astra. What is the strike range of this missile? The strike range is 70 kilometers. 70 kilometers. Bill and Melinda Gates has honored which person with the Global Goalkeeper Award? Global Goalkeeper Award was given to Narendra Modi, PM Narendra Modi. Who has become India's first female military diplomat to be posted in any of the Indian missions abroad? What is her name? She has joined the Indian Embassy in Russia and she is trained in MiG-29 fighter aircrafts. Her name is Anjali Singh. Which country has unveiled a 350 meter tall 17-story Lotus Tower, which is considered to be the South Asia's tallest tower? First of all, you should know what is the height of this tower. It is 350 meter. Don't forget this. So it is Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka. 80% of this tower is funded by China. According to United Nations report, India was the leading country of origin of the international migrants in 2019 with how many million strong diaspora. India's diaspora is largest in the world at 17.5 million, which means 17.5 million right now are working outside India in other countries. Hyderabad, Karnataka region of Karnataka has been renamed as what by the newly instilled Yediyurappa government? This region comprises of Bidar, Kalaburgi, Koppal, Ballari, Yadgir and Raichur districts. It is now called Kalyan Karnataka. Kalyan Karnataka. Which documentary film has been nominated for the Oscars? This film is based on the struggle of a farmer in a remote Uttarakhand village. It is called Moti Bagh. Very important. Moti Bagh, remember, it is based on the life of a farmer. It is a true story. The name of the farmer was Vidyadat Sharma. Vidyadat Sharma. And who is the director of this movie? Equally important. The director is Nirmal Chandar Dandriyal. Name the American swimmer who has become the first person to swim across the English Channel 4 times non-stop in 54 hours. What is the name of this American swimmer? And she is a breast cancer survivor. She is the legendary Sarah Thomas. Which state will host the United Nations International Conference on Drugs, HIV/AIDS? It will be hosted by Manipur in Imphal. Indian Air Force has started receiving the Spice 2000 bombs from which country? Remember, 2000 is not the quantity, the name is Spice 2000. So these bombs India is buying from Israel. Who has become the first Indian wrestler to qualify for the Tokyo Olympics 2020? It is Vinesh Fogart. Vinesh Fogart. In fact, recently she defeated world number 1 Sarah Ann Hildebrandt. India's first national antimicrobial resistance hub was inaugurated in which city? It was inaugurated in Kolkata. And it has been made by ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research. South Asia's first environmental school, it will come up in which state? It will be opened in Coorg. Now, Coorg is in Karnataka. Which animal has been chosen by Beijing for the 2022 Olympic Winter Games? It is panda. So, panda is the animal. And you can see the panda is named Bing Wen Wen. And then there is a Chinese child. It is called a lantern child called Shue Ron Ron. So, Bing means snow and Shue means ice. And they represent the mascot for the games. Bing Wen Wen and Shue Ron Ron. The Ministry of Home Affairs is launching India's first Central Police University in which city? It is being launched in Greater Noida, which is in Uttar Pradesh. Body Shop, which is a beauty brand, it has appointed which Bollywood actress as their new brand ambassador? She is Shraddha Kapoor. Shraddha Kapoor. Google has launched an artificial intelligence lab called Google Research India in which city? This lab has been inaugurated in Bengaluru in Karnataka. Who has been appointed as the National Security Advisor of America? He replaced John Bolton. His name is Robert O'Brien. Robert O'Brien. Who has been felicitated or honored in US with a prestigious Education Excellence Award? Education Excellence Award was given to Anand Kumar. He is the founder of Super 30. Who has been appointed as the next Air Chief? He replaced B.S. Dhanwa and his name is R.K.S. Bhadauria. R.K.S. Bhadauria. Havels India. This company has appointed which person as their brand ambassador? Their brand ambassador is Vicky Kaushal. Actor Vicky Kaushal. The government of Maharashtra, they have decided to set up Swachh Bharat World University in which city? It will be set up in Wardha. Wardha is a very important city with respect to Mahatma Gandhi because Mahatma Gandhi's Sevagram Ashram is in Wardha. Who has won the Best Actress Award at the 20th edition of the IFA Awards? These are called the Indian Film Academy Awards or IFA. Best Actress is Alia Bhatt for the movie Razi. These four awards you need to remember. Best Film is Razi. Best Actor Female is Alia Bhatt for Razi. Best Actor Male is Ranveer Singh for Padmavat. And Best Director is Shriram Raghavan for Andhadhun. Which state will observe 2020 as the year of artificial intelligence? It is Telangana. Telangana will celebrate the year 2020 as year of artificial intelligence. And the year 2019-20 in India is being celebrated as the year of construction technology, as announced by the Prime Minister Modi. The government has approved what percent interest rate on the Employees Provident Fund for the financial year that ended on 31st March 2019. The Employees Provident Fund rate that has been approved by the government is 8.65%, which is an upgradation of 10 basis points over the previous year. Last year it was 8.55. As per the Ministry of Finance, no stressed micro, small, medium enterprise assets will be declared as non-performing asset till which date? So till 31st of March 2020, any stressed MSME loans, they will not be categorized as NPAs. Ministry of HRD, they have announced a new public-private partnership scheme called NEET. What is the full form of NEET? Full form of NEET is National Educational Alliance for Technology. Option A, National Educational Alliance for Technology. And this is basically, you know, technology will be used for better learning outcomes. That is the purpose of this scheme. Securities and Exchange Board of India, they have constituted a working group on social stock exchanges under the chairmanship of which person? Chairman of this committee will be Ishat Hussain. He is the director of the SBI Foundation. Ishat Hussain. The government of India, they have announced a significant tax cut in the corporate tax. Significant reduction in the corporate tax rate for the domestic companies to what percent? So it has been reduced now to 22%. 22%. Which movie has been chosen as India's official entry for the Oscar Awards, the Academy Awards? These are called Oscars. This film is directed by Zoya Akhtar and it is called Gully Boy. Gully Boy. It is based on the life of two people, Nazi and Divine. Which state will host the country's first ever trans art festival? Country's first ever trans art festival will be hosted by Kerala. Kerala is hosting the first trans art festival. Data Security Council of India has collaborated with the Electronics and IT Ministry, that is MeitY, and which company to launch a national-wide awareness campaign called Digital Payment Abhiyan. Digital Payment Abhiyan, the partner is Google and Data Security Council of India, which works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT, headed by Ravi Shankar Prasad. Remember, this campaign is crafted in 7 languages: Hindi, English, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Bengali, and Marathi. NTPC, they are setting up India's biggest solar park in which state? The capacity is 5 gigawatt. They are setting it up in Gujarat. The answer is Gujarat. Who has created history by becoming the first Indian male boxer to reach the final of AIBA World Boxing Championship? He is Amit Pangal. Amit Pangal. Which state or union territory has launched Champions Campaign to fight dengue? Champions Campaign was launched by Delhi. Delhi is one of the endemic areas for dengue. Which dance has created history by breaking into the Guinness Book of World Record as the largest Ladakhi dance? Largest Ladakhi dance. 408 Ladakhi women, they did this dance on the occasion of Naropa Festival. It is called Shondol dance. Shondol. High Court of which state has said that right to have the internet is a part of the fundamental right under two rights: right to education and right to privacy under Article 21 of the Constitution. So right to have access to internet is a fundamental right now. It has been said by the Kerala High Court. Kerala High Court. Who has won the women's single title at the China Open? Badminton 2019. It was won by Carolina Marin of Spain. She is the reigning Olympic gold medalist. Carolina Marin had defeated PV Sindhu in the Olympics 2016 at Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. And she defeated Tai Zhu Ying in the final. The Indian Railways, they have installed a polyethylene terephthalate bottle crushing machine in which train recently? It is the first plastic bottle crushing machine in India. It has been installed in Mumbai Rajdhani Express and it can crush 3000 bottles in one day. Which state and New Jersey, they have signed a sister state agreement? Sister state agreement has been signed by Gujarat and New Jersey. The answer is Gujarat. Recently, Ahmedabad signed a sister city agreement with Kobe in Japan. Who has won the first Gauri Lankesh Award for journalism? Gauri Lankesh, on her name, the first award was given to Ravish Kumar. He also won the Ramon Magsaysay Award recently. Madhya Pradesh government has appointed which Bollywood actor as the brand ambassador to promote Madhya Pradesh's traditions and tourist places? It is effervescent Govinda. So Govinda is the brand ambassador for tourism of Madhya Pradesh. The tourism sector of which state, they have won 3 Pata Gold Awards for excellent promotion of tourism. This award ceremony took place in Nur Sultan, formerly called Astana, which is the capital of Kazakhstan. So 3 Pata Awards were given to Kerala. These are called Pacific Asia Travel Association Awards. The government has announced to set up a national e-assessment center in which of the following cities? E-assessment center will be set up in New Delhi. New Delhi. There is a military exercise called Tiger Triumph. It will be conducted between India and which country? It has been announced recently. Tiger Triumph will be conducted in Visakhapatnam and Kakinada in Andhra Pradesh. So it will take place between India and US. India and US. The Navy, they have named the seventh ship in the P-17A frigate series as what? They have called it Mahendragiri. Mahendragiri. And before this, the ships all have Giri, you know, like Nilgiri, Himgiri, Udaygiri, Dunagiri, Taragiri, and Vindhyagiri. And now the seventh ship will be called Mahendragiri. Which among the following travel groups collapsed recently due to bankruptcy? This company has become bankrupt. It is Thomas Cook. Thomas Cook, it is a British company, tour and travel company. Union government has launched which initiative to tackle inherited genetic diseases? It is UMMID. UMMID, Umeed. Umeed means hope in English. In Hindi, we pronounce it as Umeed. And there is a full form. Of course, there is a full form. It is called Unique Methods of Management. Unique Methods of Management and Treatment of Inherited Disorders. In short, Umeed. Who has won the Best FIFA Player of the Year award for a record sixth time? It was won by Lionel Messi. He won it for sixth time. And Ronaldo has won it five times. Lionel Messi plays for Argentina. The 2019 UN Climate Action Summit was held in which city? Very important. It was held in New York. And what was the theme? The theme for this summit was a race we can win, a race we must win. I repeat, a race we can win, a race we must win. Very important. New York. The tickets of which color will be issued to women passengers under the Delhi government scheme for free travel in DTC? So pink color tickets will be issued for women. Women will have free travel in the DTC buses in Delhi. Union Minister for Home Affairs Amit Shah, he recently launched three citizen-centric services of the Chandigarh Police. Which among the following was not one of them? Which among the following was not one of them? So ERSS dial 112, eBeat, eSathi, the Strike app is not one of those. So Strike is not one of those. Rest three initiatives have been launched by the Chandigarh Police. Which is the first Indian railways station to be awarded with the Green Platinum rating by the Indian Green Building Council? Which railway station? It is Secunderabad station. Secunderabad station. Who will receive this year's Dada Saheb Phalke Award? It will be given to Amitabh Bachchan by the Information Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar. Prakash Javadekar is also the Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change. How dare you? You have stolen my dreams, my childhood with your empty words. These are the words said by whom? These are the words said by Greta Thunberg, only 16 years old, and she is from Sweden. Remember her nationality, also very important. And she said these words at the UN Climate Summit in New York. The central government has introduced a new scheme, Assistance for Deep Sea Fishing for Fishermen of which state? It was launched for Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu. Which state has recently launched Aponar Apon Ghar scheme? It was launched by Assam. Basically, the financial relief will be provided if you want to buy a house, the first house for the family. It will be subsidized by the government. Aponar Apon Ghar. So Assam government. 25th Senior Women's National Football Championship has been won by which team? Who is the national women's champion now? It is Manipur. Manipur. So, in fact, Manipur are the defending champions also. And this time they defeated Railways in the final by a score of 1-0. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh has formally commissioned which Coast Guard offshore patrol vessel at the Chennai Port Trust in Chennai? What is the name of this new ship? It is Varaha. Varaha. Who has become the first woman from Arunachal Pradesh to be elevated to the rank of Lieutenant Colonel in the Indian Army? Her name is Ponung Doming. Ponung Doming. Shastra Ramanujam Prize for 2019 will be conferred on which person? This award will be given to mathematician Adam Harper. Adam Harper. Ramanujam was born in Kumbakonam in Tamil Nadu. He is one of the greatest mathematicians the world has ever seen. The 5th edition of India International Science Festival will be held in which city? India International Science Festival will take place this time in Kolkata. Which Indian girl has received the Changemaker Award at the Goalkeepers Global Goals Awards? The Global Goalkeeper Award was given to Narendra Modi, but Changemaker Award, it was given to a girl from Rajasthan, Payal Jangid. Again, very, very important question. Payal Jangid, because she has done extensive work to end child labor and child marriages in Rajasthan. Who has won the FIDE's 2019 Women's Grand Prix title? This is basically like a World Cup. So Chess World Cup female was won by Koneru Hampi. She is from Andhra Pradesh. Which IIT has developed a 1 rupee test device to measure the hemoglobin level? Now you can measure hemoglobin for only 1 rupee. This machine was made by IIT Kharagpur. Kharagpur is a place in West Bengal. National Unity and Integrity Award has been constituted on whose name? The Government of India has started this award, and this award will be given every year on the occasion of National Unity Day, which is 31st of October. It is the birthday of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, the first Home Minister of India. So the answer is Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Kristalina Georgieva. She has been selected as the new head of the International Monetary Fund. She is from which country? I repeat the question. Kristalina Georgieva is the new head of the IMF. Earlier, the IMF head was Christine Lagarde. Now she is heading the European Central Bank. So Kristalina Georgieva is from Bulgaria. Bulgaria's capital is Sofia. World Maritime Day was observed on which day? And look at the theme. Empowering women in the maritime community. This is the theme. Empowering women in the maritime community. Remember, this day is observed on the last Thursday of September. This time it is September the 26th. Who has been elected for a second term as the president of the International Association of Athletics Federation, which is headquartered in Monaco? His name is Sebastian Coe. And he is British. He is from Britain. Central government has reconstituted the Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister of India. Who is the chairman of this council? Mr. Vivek Dev Roy. He will remain as the chairman of the Economic Advisory Council. Who will take over as the new chairman of the Chief of the Staff Committee? Earlier it was B.S. Dhanwa. Now it will be Bipin Rawat. The first ever India CARICOM Leaders Summit was held in which city? First ever CARICOM Leaders Summit, it was held in New York. It is CARICOM is a grouping of the Caribbean countries. And India will benefit by solar, renewable energy and other commitments. So the answer is New York. Payment technology company Visa, they have appointed which person as their brand ambassador? So PV Sindhu is the brand ambassador for Visa. The 23rd Malabar exercise is being conducted in which city? Malabar is conducted in Sasebo, and Sasebo is in Japan. It is a trilateral exercise between India, Japan and the US. Who has been appointed as the Goodwill Ambassador for Maharashtra Assembly polls? Goodwill Ambassador is the famous actress Madhuri Dixit. Who has been honored with International Association of Athletics Federation Veteran Pin? Veteran pin was given to P.T. Usha, also called Paioli Express. She is from Kerala and she was a great Indian athlete. Who among the following has won the Sweden's Alternative Nobel Prize? Davi Kopenawa, Guo Jianmai and Greta Thunberg. The answer is all of the above. All of them were awarded the Alternative Nobel Prize. Now remember, Davi Kopenawa is from Brazil. And Guo Jianmei is from China. And one more person won it. Aminato Haidar from Western Sahara. Aminato Haidar. H-A-I-D-A-R. And of course, Greta Thunberg from Sweden. What is the rank of India in the IMD World Digital Competitiveness Index. India is ranked at a place 44. 44. So India was last year on 48th position. So we have jumped up 4 places. Number 1 is America. Second is Singapore. Who is the author of the book Reset? Regaining India's Economic Legacy. Reset is written by Subramanian Swami. The Ayush Ministry, they have unveiled which comic book series for children to make them aware of the importance of medicinal plants and their use for home remedies. It is called Professor Ayushman. He is the central character in these comics. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the International Egg Commission? He is Suresh Chitturi. An Indian has been made the chairman of International Egg Commission. World Tourism Day was observed on which date? World Tourism Day has been observed since 1980 by the UNWTO, World Tourism Organization, which is headquartered in Madrid, capital of Spain. It is observed on 27th of September. And what was the theme this year? Theme is very important. Tourism and jobs, a better future for all. Tourism and jobs, a better future for all. Which state has unveiled a mascot called Tikki Mosi to combat malnutrition among children and women? Tikki Mosi has been done by Odisha. It is a character created by Odisha. Indo-Kazakhstan joint military exercise called Kazind. It will be held in which place? Kazind will take place in Pithoragarh, which is in Uttarakhand. Which country has launched world's biggest transport spaceship called Konotori? Konotori has been launched by Japan. Green bonds called FX piles has been launched by which bank? FX piles are a green bond that are launched by the Bank of International Settlements. C. Which state has won the Best State Award for Overall Growth in Tourism category at the National Tourism Awards 2017-18? Best state overall for tourism is Andhra Pradesh. But there are 2-3 awards more, especially this one. The best film friendly state. The best film promotion friendly state is Uttarakhand. And Telangana won the award for the best state for tourism, that is using innovative use of information technology in tourism. And Goa and Madhya Pradesh, they were the joint winners in the adventure tourism category. Who has been appointed as the Vice Chief of the Indian Air Force? Vice Chief of Indian Air Force is H.S. Arora. And R.K.S. Bhadauria is the new Air Chief. The metro rail in Bhopal, it has been named after Raja Bhoj. Raja Bhoj was the ruler of which dynasty? He was from Parmar dynasty. Now remember the name Raja Bhoj because the metro in Bhopal will be named after him. As per the annual report of the airport, ACI, that is Airport Service Quality Survey conducted by the ACI, Airport Council International, ACI, which is the best airport in India in terms of the services offered to the passengers? It is the Cochin International Airport. If you remember, it had also won the UN Champions of Earth Award. Which company has received the United Nations Global Climate Action Award in the Climate Neutral Now category? It is Infosys. Infosys. What was the name of the co-owner of Mumbai's iconic eatery called Britannia & Co., who passed away recently? He was a freedom fighter also, and his name is Boman Rashid Kohinoor. Boman Rashid Kohinoor. The second Uday Express train, it was recently flagged off. It will run from Visakhapatnam to which station? It will run from Visakhapatnam to Vijayawada in Andhra Pradesh. The President of India, Ramnath Kovind, he launched the first indigenous high-temperature fuel cell system in which city? First made in India high temperature fuel cell system was inaugurated in New Delhi. It has been made by CSIR. CSIR. It was launched at Vigyan Bhavan in New Delhi. To tackle Islamophobia, Pakistan, Turkey and which country they will jointly launch an English language TV channel? So Pakistan, Turkey and Malaysia, they will launch a channel. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, they have launched which campaign to eliminate tuberculosis from India? Tuberculosis. The target is 2025 to eliminate TB from India. It is called TB Harega Desh Jitega, which means TB will lose, country will win. Which country has launched 3 commemorative coins to mark the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev Ji? Nepal will launch 100 rupee, 200 rupee and 2500 Nepali rupee coins. So the answer is Nepal. Which international airport has installed a big statue of an elephant in front of the airport? It is Bangalore International Airport. This statue has been done on the occasion of upcoming Dasera. And you can see. The first ship of the P-17A frigate, it has been named what? It was recently launched by Rajnath Singh in Mumbai. It has been called Nilgiri. The first ship is Nilgiri and the seventh ship is Mahindargiri. Don't get confused between the two. A new center of the Central Institute of Plastics Engineering and Technology, that is CIPET, it will soon come up in which state? CIPET will come up in Telangana. It will be set up in a place called Medak in Telangana. Which country will invest $100 billion in India? $75 billion will be invested by UAE and $100 billion will be invested by Saudi Arabia. Who has made history by becoming the first Arab to reach the International Space Station? His name is Haza Al-Mansouri. Haza Al-Mansouri. Very, very important. He is from United Arab Emirates. So this was the video. Best questions from September part 2. I hope you liked and enjoyed the video. And don't forget to check out the biggest sale of the year. Pen drive, tablet, Android, all courses. This sale will apply to all courses. So it is a 2-week sale from 17 to 31st of October. It is the grand Diwali sale. And I wish you all a very happy Diwali in advance. And you need to dial this number 958-004-8004. And you can visit studyiq.com. So thank you so much for watching this video. And if you like the video, don't forget to share and enjoy it by using it as a revision tool.